Nothing is permanent. Everything has an expiration date, even our Earth. While the rock we call home has the potential to float in outer space for billions of years to come, perhaps even after our sun has expanded to a red giant, its ability to host life will decline until humans can no longer survive in its harsh conditions. Some of the world's top minds, including Stephen Hawking, believe that, as a species, the number of years left on the planet could be as few as 1,000. But does this have to be the end for the human race? Not necessarily. Could we instead find another home? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer exactly those. I'm Rebecca Felgate, and today we will be discussing whether humans can live on another planet. Join us as we look at what exactly that would involve and whether we would be up for the challenge. Planet Earth has been in existence for 4.5 billion years. Humans have been around for approximately 200,000 of those, so on a grander scale, we are brand new. Many use the analogy of the 24-hour clock. If all of time on Earth were equated to one day, beginning at 12 a.m., humans would have been around since 11:59 and 59 seconds p.m. What I am getting at here is that it took a heap load of time for humans to evolve and adapt to their environment. The conditions had to be just right. We are a product of our environment, which makes living on planet Earth very, very easy. As far as we know, nowhere is exactly like planet Earth, meaning that even if we could feasibly find somewhere similar and get there, the transition would be very, very hard for us. This is the crux of the debate, but let us indulge in a little fantasy and find out whether there might be a suitable new home out there for us. In order for humans to survive, we need oxygen, water, a heat source creating a survivable climate, sleep, food, and shelter. Our new planet would need to provide the first three and accommodate the latter three, allowing us to build and farm. To cut a long story short, there is nowhere in our solar system that will comfortably provide us with these basic life requirements. So we have to look a little further afield, which is exactly what scientists and cosmologists have been doing for decades. You may be pleased to know that our searching hasn't been to no avail. We have found a few potentials. The downside is they are pretty far away. NASA's Kepler Space Observatory has been scanning the Milky Way for Earth-like planets since it was launched in March 2009. In that time, Kepler has found over 1,200 exoplanets, which means planets that orbit a star, just like us. Kepler is specifically looking for planets in habitable zones capable of fostering life. So far, there are five or so that have stood out as the most capable to handle life, and we're going to discuss a few of these potentials. Firstly, we have Kepler 62e, whose discovery was announced in 2013. Kepler 62e is a super Earth-sized exoplanet in the constellation of Lyra. It is about 60% bigger than the Earth and is in the habitable zone of a star that is smaller and cooler than our Sun. Kepler 62e orbits its Sun every 122 days, so around three times as often as we do. It is 1,200 light years away, and from the pictures received by Kepler, it is hard to know whether or not 62e is a water world or not. It could be a gaseous planet with no surface, so that wouldn't work. We simply need to examine it more to find out. Similarly, we have Kepler 62f, which is also in the constellation of Lyra. This planet is smaller than 62e, but still bigger than Earth. This planet is also quite far away from its Sun, and it is likely to have a similar temperature to Mars. Without a measured amount of carbon dioxide, the planet could be entirely ice, so really wouldn't necessarily be ideal. To put it in short terms, it's too cold. The final planet we are going to talk about is Kepler 186f, which is the only planet discovered to have a similar radius to Earth whilst also being in a habitable zone of a star. 186f is in the Cygnus constellation and orbits an M-dwarf star. Its distance away from the star means that water pooling is likely. From what we know, which is actually very little, the climate looks to be livably similar to ours on Earth. A year for 186f is 130 days, and it is 560 light years away, so pretty darn far. There is one big factor to each world that we have yet to discuss, and that is gravity. Humans have developed to look the way we do because of the Earth's center of gravity. To simplify a quite complex issue, if we lived on a planet with a different level of gravity to our Earth, the likelihood is that we would adapt and change to suit it, meaning humans as we know them may very well look different over the years to come. That is just the tip of the iceberg too. Even if small factors were changed in our home environment, big things could change in terms of our appearance as we molded to suit our new habitat. In short, humans would no longer be humans as we know them, but something pretty different. Not enough is known about any of the planets Kepler has detected, making it hard to say that we could or could not survive there or not. While the NASA Kepler Space Observatory is doing an excellent job in analyzing our galaxy, the habitable zone exoplanets it has found are not yet ready to be realistically discussed in relation to the human race's future. Not only do we not know whether or not each planet definitely hosts water and landmass, which means our ability to build shelter, drink, and eat are under threat, we do not know enough about their atmospheres, or whether they even have one, to even know if we will be able to breathe or survive the temperatures when we got there. There is also the question of travel. These planets are over 500 light years away, with one light year being around 6 trillion miles away. We haven't even come close to being able to travel the speed of light, so at least for now, these planets are unattainable. Even if they were attainable, would humans even be ready for the change, mentally and physically? I suspect, currently anyway, not. So, could humans live on another planet? Humans can survive in any environment that provides the basic elements to life: water, oxygen, food, shelter, warmth, and light. So, in theory, of course we could survive on another planet if these things were available to us. Survival and living are two different things. We couldn't live in the same way that we do now. In theory, we could survive and adapt, but life as we know it would not be the same, nor would humans as we know them. So, once again, can humans live on another planet? Sure, they can in theory, but the practice has yet to be even remotely sketched out. In short, at this point in time, we are thoroughly underprepared. How this may ever be possible would make for a very in-depth future episode of Life's Biggest Questions that may indeed need to be spanned over several parts. I'm Rebecca Felgate, this has been Life's Biggest Questions. This topic is so very vast, so if you want to discuss any part of this question that you don't think I've answered in this video, then please do feel free to write your thoughts in the comments section down below. Also, if you want to share your thoughts, opinions, and feelings on humans finding a new home, then once again, please do so in our comments section, and I will be very interested to read them. I'll also try and respond to as many as I can. For now, if you like our videos, please do subscribe to our channel so that you get regular notifications when we make new ones. If you like this video, then please do give us a thumbs up, and if you know anyone who will find this video interesting, then please do share it with them. I will see you next time, but for now, make sure you keep contemplating the answers to life's biggest questions.